Hello and welcome to Newsclick. The Competition Commission of India has ordered a probe against search engine giant Google. This was after it found that Google misused its market dominance to basically discriminate against rivals. To talk more about this, we have with us Prabir Purkayastha. Hello, Prabir. Prabir, so there are not too many details about this case. This is based on a Reuters report which has seen the document. But there's already a case from the European Commission from last year where Google was fined $5 billion on very similar charge. And the Competition Commission sources have indicated that the case was quite similar. So could you just take us through what exactly that case was and what its implications are in India?
See, without getting the details of the case, mm-hmm. the question that always comes up with respect to monopolies or what is in the US called antitrust,
right.
is that if you have a market position in which you are a monopoly of something, can we use this to try and bundle things where you are not a monopoly and thereby also make that into your monopoly?
Right.
Now this, if we look back on say Microsoft, mm-hmm. which used to be the dominant player in the PC market,
right.
at that time it used to do with Internet Explorer what's being charged against Google, now,
right.
that Chrome is being bundled in a similar fashion with Android. I'll come back to this issue. So what it means is you have to buy Windows. At that time PC platform was really Mac or Windows, and the IBM PC compatible market was a much bigger one. So everybody who bought IBM PC compatible bought Microsoft Windows to run their machines, and then a whole bunch of things came along with it.
Right.
At the time there are other also, shall we say, essentially web browsers, and Internet Explorer was a web browser. Other web browsers which are more dominant at the time had to give way to Internet Explorer mainly because of the Windows dominance. So that became the preeminent, in that sense, web browser. Android case is very similar, that exactly the charge against Internet Explorer is
right.
the charge which has come out against Google. Microsoft had to debundle, in that sense, Internet Explorer,
right.
that you could use other in web browsers, Firefox, later Chrome, but at that time Firefox was a very popular web browser. So what Google has done is something very similar.
Mm-hmm.
The Android system, which is really based on Linux, so it was in fact a Linux kernel which was used. So this is open source product.
Right.
So Google could not privatize the Android version, couldn't
right.
make money out of that. But what Google did is it created dependencies on the Android version it was selling and said if you use preloaded Android,
right.
then you have to also load Chrome
right.
as the web browser. You have also to put Google Search as the basic search engine.
Right.
So it was using the Android monopoly that it had. And let's face it, the Android today is the dominant,
right.
shall we say, the smartphone operating system,
right.
and which is where the next play is of the internet. So this monopoly that Google has over the Android ecosystem is what gives it also the monopoly over the
right.
The browser and other things.
Right.
Now, this is not the only play that Google has. In fact, the much bigger play is that it comes also with Google Play Store.
Yes,
so all the Android phones that you see in the world have Google Play Store, and the Google Play Store forces or makes it very easy for the app developers to integrate with the Android ecosystem of Google, but via the Apple Play Store,
right.
the Google Play Store. And the Google Play Store is on the cloud. That's a Google Cloud Services. Therefore, the second dependence, apart from the Android operating system itself, and that dependency can be changed as the what the European
the
Commission
European
is doing,
right.
or what the Competition Commission in India may force Google to do. But the dependency on the Apple, the dependency on the Google Play Store would still remain.
Right.
And that is the key problem that that all Android ecosystems have. And this essentially is also the problem, by the way, Huawei has
right.
at the moment.
Right.
When they are taken out of the Google Play Store, then what happens to all the Google apps,
mm-hmm.
all the other apps that run seamlessly with the Android system?
Right.
And what will happen to that is the basic threat
right.
that Huawei phones will have outside China.
Right.
And that's something that is also the issue over here.
Right. So far the antitrust regulators, both in Europe and India, their solution has of course been to levy quite substantial fines. And Google has also responded by giving users an option to download other browsers, of course, and also make the other browsers default browsers in their individual phones. But like you said, it does not really solve the problem of the Play Store, which is actually where the more substantial issue is.
You see, this is the, shall we say, how monopolies operate. Mm. This is not something that we are unaware of.
Right.
This is how all monopolies have behaved in the past. If I have a monopoly in one sector, how can I use it to have monopoly in other sectors? Mm. In this case, it was really the operating system monopoly, which paved the way by Microsoft earlier,
right,
with the Windows operating system, with Linux giving it competition, and also the fact that Apple has also become a major player again, mm-hmm, in the PC market. That is a weakening monopoly.
Right.
But still, let's face it, Windows or Microsoft, one of the major revenue still of Microsoft is to sale of software.
Right.
I think 60% of their revenue comes from Windows, Word, and other services, other software that they provide. Leaving that out for the time being, if we come back to what Apple, Apple has done, shall we say, not Google, but what Apple has done, they have built their own ecosystem completely. Now, anybody who wants to challenge Google today will have to consider how to build their own ecosystem, a completely new ecosystem. Otherwise, Google's monopoly is going to remain not only in search engine, not only on things like Google Map, not only on Gmail, all of these things, but the fact that Android is the de facto operating system today. In India, for instance, 98% of phones apparently use Android. So the question that remains is, do we have an alternative to the Android ecosystem, not just the Android phone?
Right.
You see, the Android-based operating system can be very easily changed with an alternate Linux kernel. Android itself actually was bought by Google at one point of time. It was based on a Linux kernel, and it cannot be made closed source because it was always based on a open, free and open source software. So that kernel is open. That can be forked by anybody. But the real problem is today the app-based provisions, because without the apps, the phone is in some sense very, very of limited use.
Right.
Because smartphones use a lot of apps, and some of the apps are standard, there you have the problem. So yes, you can get, the Google's Chrome, you can use Firefox instead, you can get other things out of the dependency that is there on the phone, or which the phone manufacturers have had supposed to submit to Google if they want the Android as a already downloaded stuff. Already, when you order a phone, it comes along with the phone. So if you do all of that, even then, that Android-based dependency is really on the cloud.
Right.
Now, one must understand what happens about Google. Google is quite willing to pay the future $5 billion in fines for having got Android into the preeminent position of the European market. And say the Indian company, the Indian arm, or Google itself, is an American company, is fined by the Competition Commission, say, X number of dollars. Now, having captured 98% of the Indian market, Google might be quite willing to pay the fine as a capital investment, shall we say, in the monopoly it has created. So these fines, they're quite happy to pay the fines in lieu of the monopoly they have got for 5, 8, 6 years, whatever the duration might be. And that's a long game that Google is playing. Mm-hmm. And many jurisdictions, there will be no fines. Mm. So even the fines, in some sense, are expenditure which Google is willing to undertake in order to achieve the monopoly.
Right. And do you see the possibility of, say, a company like Huawei being able to actually generate its own ecosystem as an alternative? Because that is one of the options they are considering, to build a Huawei Play Store which has its own series of apps.
You know, the challenge for the world is that if we don't want to succumb to companies like Google and so on internationally, what are the options they will have? Mm. And this is true for Chinese, obviously, Russia, little less so, but definitely at any point of time, any of the companies can be sanctioned.
Right.
So these are those who already have strategic competition in the United States and who can be easily taken out of the US, shall we say, domains in by use of sanctions. So suddenly all the US products becomes out of bounds for it. So what do they do? So I think they have no alternative but to do what we India called self-reliance for a long time, or shall we say technological sovereignty again, which means you need to have options by which, whether it is hardware or software, you should be able to be completely self-reliant.
Right.
You may not be so, but you have to aim to be so.
Right.
So in case that you have an existential crisis like the Huawei has, then you can say, okay, what is the gap now I need to cover in order to become independent?
Right.
And I think that is the challenge that, for instance, Huawei has.
Mm-hmm.
It's, they have been looking at different things. They have been looking at, say, companies which have now almost died, and whether they have an app store which they can take over. They're looking at Russians, what is the Russian apps which are there. So they are on the hunt for a quick way to create their Play Store equivalent.
Right.
And let's see, there are two precedents to this, so it's not that difficult to do either, but it's big bucks.
Right.
So one is Apple, which has built its Apple Store, by which you can get the apps from Apple. They integrate seamlessly with Apple because the hardware is all the same. So in fact, the integration is even easier because the target hardware is not as varied and as, shall we say, different from each other as the Google ecosystem has. And the second is Amazon Fire Stick, for instance.
Mm-hmm.
That also seems to have built a whole bunch of applications or apps which are independent of the Google Play Store.
Right.
And therefore, these big companies are already thinking ahead that they cannot afford to be dependent on Google.
Right.
And this is the route that Huawei or any other company has to travel. It's clear that Huawei is being forced to travel this route. They didn't want to.
Right.
They would like to compete in the European market and in the third world market with products which people don't see it as dissimilar, which also have the familiar Google stuff on it, because Google still controls a large part of the search engine, the Google Maps, the Gmail, and also the Google Docs now, etc., including the search engine, which is where the contention has come out. So I think all of this, we have to see how it goes. But we are seeing a long-term battle against Google's monopolies or the monopolies of big American companies, because it's clear that we are in today entering into global trade wars, and what in Newsclick we have earlier says also technological wars or tech wars. So I think that's where it is. It's going to be a rocky road. I don't think the globalized united world, which was the sort of the slogans, it was all the slogans, which was given, is actually working at the moment.
Right.
But behind this is a really an attempt to reassert dominance of certain countries, companies, or through some companies, certain countries asserting their dominance over the rest of the world, which is where the competition commissions are now waking up to the threats. Europe is waking up to the threats of American digital companies taking over their space. And in fact, the only ones today who are able to challenge it is, because they have a huge market, internal market, is the Chinese companies, to a lesser extent Russia, because they have good technological strength, but they really do not have as big a market as the Chinese have. The population of Russia is small.
Right.
Russian is not a popular language internationally, so it doesn't have the numbers required to really create a large market base. So we have to see how Russia and China, whether they will come together strategically, even on the digital tech sector, as it were.
Thank you, Prabir. That's all we have time for today. Keep watching Newsclick.